Hello, my name is Gloria Gerd, and I am the mother of makeup art, and welcome to my show, Artist Highlights. I am here with Kristen Brown. She's a Baltimore artist, and I met Kristen at Micah Place at an art conference. And Kristen, tell us about yourself. Where did you come from? Were you born in Baltimore or someplace else?
So I came to Baltimore from Illinois, which is where I had previously lived my whole life, and now I've been in Baltimore for 2 years, and this will be my third year.
You are a photographer, by trade. I knew you from Viewfinders. Mm-hmm. As a child, did you like to take pictures?
You know, I don't think I really got into photography until high school. I took a photography class. I've always enjoyed art and crafts, and my family always thought of me as the artsy one. but I never considered myself an artist really until college. Yeah, I went to college as an education major, starting out as an education major, and then the spring semester of my junior year decided to switch to become an art major have been doing it since.
That's wonderful.
Yeah.
How did you get involved with Micah Place and Viewfinders and Video Lab?
Yeah, so I moved to Baltimore for grad school. Like I said, I made that switch in undergrad to study art, but more specifically, I was studying community art. So I've always approached art less through a personal practice, but more about doing it with other people. And so Micah is one of the few places that has a community art program. So after I graduated my undergrad, I decided I needed more time and structure to kind of explore what I wanted to do. So I decided to come to Micah for the MFA in Community Arts program. And then my first year here for the program, I started working at Viewfinders, which is an after-school program, and many other things, one of which is Video Lab. And so part of working with Viewfinders, I also worked here at Video Lab.
Tell us about this mural project that you have going on.
So as part of our after-school program, I'm the teaching artist. And over the past 2 years, we've been doing a series of projects about identity. And part of that has been, we've been asking the question, how do we become the people we want to be? So thinking about that question, we started studying different heroes that we had. And so for one project, each of the youth chose a hero that they had and researched them and thought through why they were their hero, and then we created these collages where the image was, it was a portrait of half of their hero and half of them posing as their hero. So we made these and I just kind of like fell in love with them, but I never knew where we were going to go with
them.
They
sound wonderful.
And then a year later, some funding came along for a partnership with a Micah student to do murals. And so honestly, I was pretty like, I'm never gonna do murals because I don't paint. I was like, I don't know how I could do murals if I don't paint. But I learned about this process called Polytab, which is a fabric you can print images on and then glue to the wall. And it's more permanent than like wheat pasting would be. So I learned that process, and now we like 6 of those images are up as murals in the East Baltimore neighborhoods.
And I have seen these murals, y'all, and they're beautiful.
Thank you.
Who was that student that told you about that?
Ben Hamburger.
Oh,
he's a good friend of mine, and he taught me how to do. You interviewed him.
Yeah, interviewed him.
He taught me how to do the Polytab process, so I will be forever grateful for that because I have a feeling it's not ending with this project.
Yeah. Tell me a little bit about Polytab.
Yeah, so it's a fabric that was actually originally used to line men's suits. And these artists in the Philadelphia Mural Arts Program, I don't know how they figured this out, but they figured out you could either paint on it or you can print on it, and then it can be glued to the wall with a really a special glue that when it dries kind of turns into like a plastic, and so it protects the mural, and there's a lot of awesome benefits of working with the material versus painting directly on the wall, because it opens up a bunch of possibilities.
It sounds fascinating.
Yeah.
You have a special community event coming up. Tell us about that event, please.
So on October 14th, we're inviting anyone to come and celebrate all these murals with us. It starts at 2:00 at Micah Place, which is 814 North Collington Avenue. And we're gonna start here at Micah Place and get ready for a walking tour that we're gonna have of all the murals. And it's also kind of like a parade. So while we're here, we're gonna be getting little art elements we can wear and making noisemakers, face paint, lots of stuff.
Fun.
And then we'll walk to each mural site, and at each site there'll be a different activity or performance led by community members and the youth who are helping plan the event.
Please tell my audience how they can find more information about you and see more of your art.
So, two ways. A lot of the work we've been doing that we've talked about here can be found at baltimoreviewfinders.org, where you'll see pictures of the murals and more about the event. And then my personal website is www.kristenleebrown.com, which has some of my older projects and some of my personal artwork as well.
It's just been great talking to you.
Thank you.
And I've been knowing you 2 years. We've been working together, and I just love it.
I
wish
it
you
too.
Lots of success.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Thank you for watching my show, Artist Highlights. If you're interested in being on my show, please go to my website, gloriazart.com, and let me know. I look forward to hearing from you.